Good morning, children. How are you? I hope you must have enjoyed the last class. In the last class, we learnt about the determiners. And now, here I am with you to share some of the important things about tense, which is one of the most important things. Children, before starting this study, topic on tense, I would like to give you one simple suggestion that if you want to master an English grammar, you must have a complete knowledge of tense. A tense, what is a tense? How many kinds of tense are there? We are going to discuss in this video. See children, what is a tense? According to the definition, tense is the study of the different forms of verbs. When we talk about the different forms of verb, a question comes in our mind, how many types of forms are there of a verb? So here, there are five forms of verb: V1, V2, V3, V4, V5. So V1 is called base form or present form. V2 is called the past form. V3 is known as past participle form. V4 is known as gerund form. V5 is called present participle form. So why, how we are going to make a present tense, different forms of the verb? Here I would like to give you a little bit detail of this one. V2, how we make V2? V1 plus D or ED or T is equal to V2. When we add D, ED or T in V1, in most of the verb forms, it turns into V2. In the same way, when we add ED or T in V1, it turns into V3, which is the past participle form of the verb. V1 plus ING is equal to V4. When we add ING in V1, it turns into V4, which is called a gerund form. And in V5, when we add S or ES, it becomes V5. So one very important thing I would like to tell you, that V1 is plural form of the verb. V1 is plural form of the verb. Plural verb. V1 is a plural form of the verb. At the same time, V5 is a singular form of the verb. V5 is always singular and V1 is always plural. So, now, we are coming to the main topic about the tense. There are three kinds of tense. There are three kinds of tense: present tense, past tense, future tense. So, in that present tense, past tense, future tense, present tense is related with the present time, past is related with that past time, and future tense is related with those actions which is going to be happen in the coming time. So, again, I am drawing your attention in that one circle. There are four subdivisions of each tense. There are four subdivisions of each tense. Children, see here. Is tense has got four subdivisions. They are first simple indefinite, second continuous, third perfect, fourth is perfect continuous. In this way we have 4 into 3 is equal to 12, 12 sextant to study in tense. Now, how it becomes 12? For example, present tense. With the help of the arrow you can understand present tense, that is simple present tense or present indefinite, present continuous, present perfect continuous simultaneously, past indefinite, past continuous, past perfect continuous, and in the same way, future tense, simple future, future continuous, future perfect continuous. Now, we are coming to our first one, that is simple present tense. What is a simple present tense? What are its structure? How we are going to use it? We shall discuss in this one. See. The structure 1, structure A and the structure B. The structure A of simple present tense is subject plus V1/V5 plus object, and a structure B is subject plus is am are plus object. So first we will discuss about subject, the structure number A. Subject plus V1 or V5. Here you are watching two arrows which are crossing each other. So here, where we have to use V1 and where we have to use V5, we have to see a little bit, we have to pay a little bit attention over here. With he, she, it, one name, we have to use V5. Here you are watching an arrow. And with I, we, you, they and names, we will use V1. So if V5 is used when the subject is singular, here it is written, V5 is used when the subject is singular, and in the box you are watching, and V1 is used when the subject is plural. Here it is written, and I, plural and I. Again, I would like to draw attention over here. V5 is used when the subject is singular, and at the same place, V1 is used when the subject is plural and I. We use the verb according to the subject. We have to use V1 or V5 according to the subject. Now we are coming to our next structure, that is subject plus is am are plus of. This is also called the structure of simple present tense. So to show the nature of the subject, where subject plus is am are plus object is used, it is used to show the nature of the subject. For example, here in the middle you are watching is in a brown letter. And in the red letter, 1, 2, 3, 4 is the coal, mother, milk, snake. In the first you are watching coal, in the next you are watching mother, in the third you are watching milk, and in the fourth you are watching snake. Here, the nature of all these subjects are here: black, kind, fearful, white. So, what is the nature of a particular subject? It can be seen here, 1, 2, 4, 3 here. I mean, its answer is there. Coal is black. This is the nature of coal. It is black. Mother is kind. This is the nature of mother. Mother is always kind. Milk. Milk is white. This is the nature of the milk, that its color is white. Snake. Snake is pure. Fearful. Snake is fearful. Children, you must have seen. When you see a snake, you get afraid. Oh my God, what did I say? Oh, okay. So, these are the nature of the is am are. Subject plus is am are plus object, which is also a structure of simple present tense. It shows the nature of the subject. And in the next session, we shall discuss more about the simple present tense, its correct uses. So children, in today's class, in today's video, we learnt about the introduction of tense. What is a tense? It's different kinds. It's different subdivisions and the structure, and we also discussed about the structure of simple present tense. We shall discuss more about the usage of simple present tense in our next video. Thank you, children.